We will bring the light into you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night, when our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, passed from death to life, the Church invites all of her children throughout the world to come together in vigil and in prayer. This is the Passover of the Lord. And if we honor the memory of his death and his resurrection by hearing his word and celebrating these mysteries, we may be confident that we shall share Christ's victory over death and live with Christ forever and ever. And so we pray, gracious God, we share in the light of the glory of your Son, Jesus Christ, the light of the world. We ask you to make this new fire holy and inflame us all with new hope. Purify our minds by this Easter celebration and bring us one day to the feast of eternal life. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We bless this candle. Lord, you are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We also remember your five wounds and the love that brought you to the cross. And so we light this candle, the light of Christ. And may the light of Christ Christ, dispel the darkness of our hearts and our minds, and may we always live as children of the light. And may we always live as
Christ our light,
thanks be to God.
Christ our
Christ.
Thus evening came and morning followed. first day. Then God said, let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other. And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin so that the dry land may appear. And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth. And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on the earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky. And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, be fertile, multiply, and fill the water of the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth. Evening came, and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds. And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground. God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth. God also said, see, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food. And to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground, I give all the green plants for food. And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. Since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing, he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
us now to perceive how still more wonderful is the new creation by which you have redeemed your people through the sacrifice of our Passover, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward, and you, lift up your staff, and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God who had been leading Israel's camp now moved and went around behind them. The column of cloud also, leaving the front, took up its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to the right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went after them right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it into a panic, and he so clogged their chariot wheels they could hardly drive. With the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn, the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea when the Lord hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped. But the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to the right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang a song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost. Drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread? Your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David, as I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander of nations. So shall you summon a nation you knew not, and nations that knew you not shall run to you. Because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous and forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways. Thus says the Lord, as high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down, and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows, and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Look with mercy and favor on your entire church. Bring lasting salvation to humanity, so that the world may see the broken healed, the old made new, and all things brought to perfection through the one who is their origin, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
From sin. If then we have died with Christ, We believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
This is like the marathon, okay? This is like, if you get through this, you can get through any mass. So you know. I was thinking about, you know, we hear this gospel every Easter. And I'm wondering what we really believe in. Is it a fable? Is it a myth? Is it a nice story? I wonder how many people come to church and it doesn't really affect them. You know, I can hear somebody saying, "Listen, Father, you know what? I still got to go to work on Monday. Whether Jesus rose from the dead or didn't, it doesn't matter. I still got work." But it does matter. Because if we don't believe that Christ rose from the dead, then our faith is in vain. This is the mystery of our faith. That new life comes from the tomb and that he's not in the tomb anymore. He is not there. He has risen, as the angel says. He is no longer here. He is risen. And if that's the truth, then it means that we also live forever. Think about that. Because I'm thinking, you know, I only got about 20 years left, maybe, if I'm lucky. And we're going to live forever. The adventure is just starting. And whether we live to be 100, or we live to be 30, or we live to be 10, the adventure continues on. And that changes what we do here. We don't have to get everything in, like our culture says. We don't have to make as much money as we can make. We don't have to be busy about so many things. But what does Christ say at the end of his life? Just love. Love the people in your life. Love the people that come into your life. Love the people who are unlovable. That will be your legacy. Because you don't have to prove it to anybody else. Matthew and Emiliano, this has been a great journey to be with both of you. These guys are stellar. They are stellar men, you know? And I kept thinking, what if I get two that I don't really like? I'd have to still say, oh, you were good. No. But you are great. You are really wonderful. I love you both. And I was thinking, you know, we think that we make the decision a lot of times, you know, about coming into the faith, you know, and being baptized. But I think that God has had his eye on both of you. Matthew received his first catechism in the cigar bar by his sponsor, the Godfather. But that's how God works. And Emiliano received it from friends and from his family and from people who loved him. But I've watched both of you. You know, you've had your bumps, you've had some hard days, you've had stuff that didn't go your way, but you didn't give up. You kept going. That's the grace of God. That's saying, you know what? We're okay. We're going to make this. Because God is bigger than whatever problem I have. Today, I think that a lot of times we just struggle with, what are we supposed to do? You know, what are we supposed to do with our lives? Right here is what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to live each day with as much power, passion as you can. I'm going to steal something from one of the bishops. Let me just see. He says that Easter is not a time to count our blessings. That's for Thanksgiving. This is Bishop Utner, who is bishop in Saginaw. And besides, a whole lot of people in this world don't have all those blessings. He said, but at Easter, we go to the heart of it. We celebrate the fact that we just exist, that we are the gift of God, and we have the gift of our human existence. What a gift. It's all that matters. It's the beginning of a wondrous human life that will be transformed and go on forever and ever and ever. Whatever our condition now, this is only a flicker of time. It's only a tiny mustard seed destined to blossom and substitute into something strong and beautiful. And in the meantime, in the midst of our life, we do as much good as we can do. We take care of each other. We don't have to be about ourselves. We're about somebody else. So my brothers, we celebrate with you this day. Somebody said, this looks like a casket. Isn't that something, Emiliano? Your beautiful baptismal font looks like a casket to me. But in some ways, it is, because you are dying to who you were in some ways. You're dying to the stuff that you don't have to carry anymore. You're dying to the old self that maybe put yourself down. You're dying to the stuff that was not good in your life. You're dying to that stuff so that the new man can come out. When we confirm you, my good brother Matthew, thank God we don't have to get you in this tub. When we confirm you, because you've already been baptized, we anoint you with the oil and say, Holy Spirit, give him the strength and the power to do the great things he has to do in his job as a deputy. To do those hard stuff of dealing with some folks that are difficult and the unloved oftentimes. You both are going to get great power in this moment. And all I can say is, I can't wait to see the great things you do in the world and the great things you do with your lives. So we are blessed to have you both joining the church. The Catholic Church is richer because you're both in it. And thank you for the journey you've been to me. Amen. Before we have the profession of faith, I'd like to bless the waters. We're going to go to the pot and bless that water, and then bring some water up here. You want to look back? O God, who by invisible power accomplish a wonderful effect through sacramental signs, and in whom many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit, in the first moments of the world's creation, hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and a beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry-shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people would be set free from slavery to Pharaoh, would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side, along with his blood. And after his resurrection, he commanded his disciples, go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water, received by the Holy Spirit, the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism, from the squalor of the life of old may be found worthy to rise to new life. And may the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this body. And so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
So, Emiliano, I invite you to come forward with your sponsor and with your family. My dear brother, before you go into the waters of baptism, I ask you, do you renounce Satan and evil and violence and all of its forms? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, he was crucified, he died and was buried, but he rose on the third day? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of our sins, the resurrection of our bodies, and life everlasting? My dear brother, this is our faith, and this is the faith we pass on to you, and you accept that faith. Is that right? Amen. All right, good. He said, no, we'd be in trouble. So I'm going to invite your mom, but also your whole family to come around you. We're going to pray to the saints to come around Emiliano at this important moment in his life. And so we ask the saints from your family as well as the saints.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint Michael.
desire to do this? All right. The water is very cold, so we can roll our ice down. Can I take your shoes off? The rest of the family, or anybody else that wants to come around here, please. Either way. My dear brother Emiliano, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Singing Hallelujah, please. Dear brother, we give you this white garment to put on. It's a sign of your purity and your goodness. And when you wear that purity, so that when people don't see you, they see in you. And so, as we celebrate this baptism, I also invite us to stand and to renew our own baptismal commitment. So I ask you to renounce Satan and evil and violence and racism in all of its forms.
I
believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I
believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, he was crucified, he died, and was buried, but he rose on the third day.
I
believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of our sins, the resurrection of our bodies, and life everlasting. Dear brothers and sisters, this is our faith. This is the faith that gets us excited. This is our faith in Jesus Christ. Let the church say, Amen. And so I'm going to invite you to bless yourself in the font. And what I'd like to do you to do is to bless the person who's behind you, too. All right, so we just bless each other. We're in this together. All right, so however you want to do it, but we have some time because Emiliano is getting dressed. So that's what you call a commercial. So please go and bless each other. Please, family, come up there. So.
Oh,
It's a sign of the light of Christ. And you carry that light throughout your life. And in that moment, when you see Christ, may that light be bright. I would invite my brother Matthew and his sponsor to come up. My brother Matthew, of your own free will, you have asked to be received into the full communion of the Catholic Church. You have made your decision after careful thought under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. I now invite you to come forward with your sponsor. In this faith, you will be one with us for the first time at the Eucharistic table of our Lord Jesus, the sign of the Church's unity. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so, my dear brother, I invite you to make the following profession of faith. I believe and profess all that the Holy Catholic Church believes, teaches, and proclaims to be revealed by God. My dear brother Matthew, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has led you here so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith that you have professed in the presence of his family. My brother, you're really Catholic now. All right. I invite Emiliano to come up as well. You'll carry it now by yourself. My dear candidates for confirmation, in your baptism, you have been born again in Christ, and you have become members of Christ and of his priestly people. Now you would share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord upon his apostles at Pentecost and given by them as their successors to the baptized. The promised strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive now, will make you more like Christ and help you be witnesses to his suffering, his death, and his resurrection. It will strengthen you to be the active members of the Church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and in love. So, my dear friends, we pray to God our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit on Matthew and Emiliano for confirmation and to strengthen them with his gifts and anoint them to be more like him. Invite the family to come around again.
Thank you.
I invite your sponsors to place their right hands on your shoulder. Almighty and gracious God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon these good men, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, powerfully. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Use chrism at this time as a sign that you are anointed by the Holy Spirit. My dear brother, be sealed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. So let us stand and bring our prayers to
you. For the church, that we will continue to be instruments of Christ's light for all who have lived in darkness, of hope for all who know pain and suffering, and of love for all who have been rejected. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are joining the Catholic faith tonight, that they may grow in holiness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have been confirmed tonight, especially Matthew, and Emiliano, that they will persevere faithfully in all that God asks of them, enrich the church community with their gifts, and manifest the reign of God in their words and deeds. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the afflicted, the hungry, the homeless, and the sick, that the light of the risen Christ may shine upon them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who thirst for something more in life, that they may come to the living water that satisfies all the longings of the human heart, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a deepening of our commitments, that we who have renewed our baptismal promises may profess through our actions the Lordship of Jesus and live faithfully as children of the light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people in Ukraine, Gaza, and around the world harmed by violence and instability, may God bless and console them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially family members and friends of all gathered here tonight, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Joe and Evelyn Barsinski, whom we remember in a special way at this liturgy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Good and gracious God, we thank you for this night, which reminds us of the new life you offer to all of us. So help us, Lord, to live our lives fully and with passion. We bring you these simple prayers in the name of the risen one, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
If you see.
Thank you.
And so pray, my friends, that this sacrifice and the sacrifice of our lives might be acceptable to our loving God. May the Lord
accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise of the Lord in his name, for our good and the cause of his Holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of us, your faithful people, with these sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in this Paschal mystery may, by the working of your power and your love, bring us to the healing of all eternity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up, Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. It's our duty, our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this night, especially, above all, to laud you even more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he's destroyed our death, and by rising, has restored all of us to life. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land and every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with all the angels, with all of our holy ancestors, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim. Jesus took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and again he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim the work of your love and until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of our salvation. Put your favor on the offering of your church, and would you show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and to true charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of all of our brothers and sisters, especially those who are most vulnerable among us. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are so heavily burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command of love. May your church stand as a living witness to truth and to freedom, to peace and to justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. And remember all of our brothers and sisters, in a special way, remember Joe and Evelyn at this Mass, who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ. Admit them now to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. And we thank you for their lives, and for the goodness they brought to their families, and to so many others. And grant also to us, that when our earthly pilgrimage is over, that we may come to the eternal dwelling place, and live with you forever, there in communion with Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, with the apostles, the martyrs, with Saint Emiliano and Saint Matthew, Saint Lucy and Saint Michael, and all the saints, that we might join them one day and praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord. Through with him in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
My dear brothers and sisters, this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. This is our beloved Christ, the risen one, who comes to bring us new life and to bring us great hope. So how happy we are to be called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but once you say your word, my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Thank you.
Announcements. A movie about the life of Saint Francis Cabrini is playing in local theaters for a short time this week. If you are able and would like to join us, a group of parishioners will be attending the 1:30 p.m. showing on Tuesday, April 4th, at the Marcus Valley Grand Theater, located near Lowe's in Appleton. Learn more about your faith and have popcorn, too. There will be a free organ recital here at St. Joe's on Friday, April 5th at 7:30 p.m. The event is put on by the Wisconsin Organ Historical Society. Each year we provide little white books with a daily reflection during the Easter season. These books are available in the back of the church. Thank you to a generous parishioner for picking up the cost of these books. The parish office is closed on Monday. Have a happy and blessed Easter.
This is from all of us and staff, and I just wish everyone a happy Easter and just a really a wonderful time. And again, Matthew and Emiliano, you make us proud and you give us so much joy, you know, you give us hope that the church is still going, you know, so thank you. Thank you. Birthdays this week. I know we're running late. It's almost 2 hours. Too much church tonight. So birthdays this week, or next week, or in the month of May. Hey, oh yeah. I go for May. Oh look, Deb, that's right. Is it, when is it? The first April Fool's. Oh, no, that's a terrible day. And that's a good day because you were born that day. Yeah. April 1st. When? Well, then you're over there somewhere. Yeah. April 1st is right there. Yeah. Anybody else know? Come on. Oh, good. Owen, when is it? Last week. Okay, then you're over here. Yeah. Anybody from the family now? Come on. Oh, come on. Get up here. When is it? Yesterday. Oh, see, you were trying to sneak. But we got snitches. We got snitches. All right, good. Anybody else? Anybody want to tell on anyone? Lord, we are just so grateful as we celebrate these birthdays and as they fall right around Easter. We pray for these wonderful people. And as they celebrate their birthdays, may it be a great year. May it be a new year, a new adventure. May they realize how deeply they're loved by you and by so many people in their lives. May they meet new people that maybe will even change their life. And may they continue to have the courage and the strength to follow you wherever you lead them. So Lord, just give them a great year ahead. Help them to stay healthy. And help them again to just know that you walk with them through all the moments of their life. So may God's blessing be upon you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Brother Rick recommitted himself to the priesthood again. And you know, he gives so much to our parish and the community. I think a big thank you for Brother Rick.
Great hall, so please come by and get a piece of cake or a cupcake.